Thanks for joining us here on the web. Police in Nottingham need the public's help in finding a missing woman. Police say 74-year-old B. Ann Brazell was on her way to her house in Portsmouth around 10 a.m. yesterday, but she never made it. She's 5 feet 2 inches tall, weighs around 120 pounds, has brown hair, hazel eyes. She was last seen driving a four-door silver VW Golf with New Hampshire license plates 84467. Police were able to trace her cell phone to the Route 101 area of Epping. Right now, state police and local police are searching that area. If you've seen Miss Brazell or if you've heard from her, you're asked to call Nottingham Police. Their number is 679-1506. Meantime, a Concord man is accused of attacking another man with a splitting maul, similar to an axe. 33-year-old Christopher Jackson is now charged with 3 felonies, including first-degree assault. Police say that the attack happened yesterday afternoon in a homeless camp behind the Everett Arena. Ray Brewer has the latest.
He just swings it once, and then he's just yelling.
Corey Edwards says the attack at this campsite Monday afternoon, allegedly by Christopher Jackson, who was arraigned by video, seemed to come out of nowhere.
But I've known CJ since 2007, and I've never seen CJ ever act like this.
Jackson is accused of swinging an axe at Peter Levesque. Edwards says that Levesque tried to defend himself.
And they've told him that if he didn't go up like this, he could be gone.
Edwards says it was actually a splitting maul that Jackson swung and hit the victim with the maul side, then yelled at Levesque.
He was that upset that he's like, you're lucky I didn't have it flipped around.
The attack left Levesque with a broken right wrist and a cut to the head, according to police. In addition to the felony assault charge, Jackson is also charged with tampering for allegedly telling Levesque that if he spoke to police, they would be lucky to find even his fingertip.
I know Chris was on edge, but I didn't think that he would just outright attack.
Andrew Thompson lives in a neighboring tent. He says what Jackson is accused of doing was totally out of character, although like many veterans, he does have some issues.
They need help, and they're not getting the help they need. But as far as being a nice guy and get along, joke around guy, he's great. And, you know, he couldn't ask for a better friend.
Now, that was our Ray Brewer reporting. In court today regarding Jackson's military record, the prosecution said it looks like he was mustered out after boot camp. Still, the defense said that Jackson was diagnosed with post-traumatic stress disorder and asked that he be sent for evaluation. But the judge called Jackson a danger to the public, and he set bail at $60,000. Police in Salem had to taser a man who led them on a chase on a moped that investigators think was stolen. Officers tried to stop Rafael Tejada on Clough Crossing Road, but he sped up, crossed the street, then started driving the wrong way in traffic. Later, police say he darted in front of a police cruiser, causing a minor crash between 2 police cars. Then officers say he crashed into some brush. That's when he was tasered and arrested. He's now facing 6 charges. Manchester police arrested a man accused of exposing himself in public. 35-year-old Oscar Quinta is accused of exposing himself on at least 3 separate occasions. The most recent allegedly happened last night at the Stop and Shop Plaza on Valley Street. Police say Quinta had a young boy with him at the time when he allegedly exposed himself to a woman as she was leaving the Family Dollar store there. Quinta now faces several charges, including 4 counts of indecent exposure, and he's being held on $50,000 cash bail. Police say both speed and alcohol were factors in a deadly crash in Derry last night. Officers say 40-year-old Ignatius Cimino of Lawrence, Massachusetts, crashed his motorcycle on North Shore Road around 7 o'clock and was not wearing a helmet. He sustained serious head wounds and died at the hospital. That does it for us for now here on the web. Have a great afternoon, everybody.